Hey guys, Thunder E here, and yes, there is a brand new BlackBerry. Yeah, this is the BlackBerry Key 2, successor to the Key 1, and I have to tell you though, BlackBerry's coming strong with this device. Now, you're going to see a lot of hands-on videos and what have you about the Key 2, but this video is focused on five features that I think BlackBerry brings to the table that sets it apart from other devices. We've got a packed smartphone here, we know that. So why would you pick up a BlackBerry Key 2? Now, I spent some good time with this device last week, and I'm gonna showcase some of the things I really think BlackBerry brings to the table. So let's start off with the first one, the keyboard. Now, not everyone wants a touchscreen, and some people want that nostalgia. The Key 1 brought the keyboard back, but the Key 2 takes it to a whole new level and redefines it. It is much easier to type on this keyboard. Yes, I've got bigger fingers and big hands, so I thought it would be more difficult, but it felt more comfortable to type on that. I needed to get back into it, the swing of things, but I think a lot of people will like that if you want that tactile feel with that. Much more flush. Plus, the fact that you have those keys programmable. So you can program those keys 52 times pretty much. So basically long press and short press to either any application, contacts, or anything you want to program it to on the device, which gives you multitasking on a different level. Now that brings us to our second feature, which is the brand new key button there. That basically looks like a little BlackBerry logo on the corner, right-hand side of the keyboard. That allows you to now officially switch between applications without going to the home screen. So in the Key 1, you could actually go ahead and long press or short press to a shortcut, but to go to another one, you had to go back to the home screen and then do the same function again. Now with that active button, you can go ahead and switch between, say, maps to, you know, say, you know, your contact list, or to a different app, to a camera, you name it, to Chrome. You can switch left and right by just holding out that button. And that gives a different level of productivity and functionality on the device that no other device has. There's no way to actually do that hub swap to exactly what you want. And I think BlackBerry does that, especially thinking about that productive mindset, which is very, very good. Another thing, sorry, on this device that I'd like to mention is battery life. Now, the Key 1 had really good battery life. This is aiming for more than 2 days of battery life. Yes, more than 2 days. It's got a massive battery in there. Again, doesn't feel heavy. It's about, I think, a 3500 milliamp battery. It's on screen if I made a mistake there. But what you have here is something that really pushes the boundary of battery life, making sure you have a device that lasts long. And I mean, the old BlackBerries used to last long anyway, so BlackBerry's tried to ensure that they have the same reputation here with this device. Now, it's paired with a Snapdragon 660, which makes it even better because you don't need all that performance. You're not gaming heavily with this device. Yes, you can, but this is not an 800 series processor, so you're not focused on that. You're focused on basically that battery life, performance, and also just, you know, longevity on this device, which is great. You've also got 6 gigs of RAM on here and expandable storage. It can go up to 256 in terms of inbuilt storage, expandable via micro SD. So you've got all that built in the Key 2. And I think the battery life option really brings a lot of things to the table for a lot of people. Now, the fourth thing is, of course, security, which actually should be the first, but it's something BlackBerry has done for such a long time. And this also extends with their DTEC software, giving you more functionality built in. There's a lot of things they have there with that. One, of course, giving you the ability to set those permissions for apps, which is something we hear a lot. We're in the age where privacy is now a big concern for a lot of people. A lot of the applications like to have access to everything. You have a calendar, or even say a clock accessing your contacts and things like that. You can turn off those specific permissions, or you can set the permissions the way you want, which gives you, the user, the power in your hands. And I like that aspect about that. There's also, of course, the new locker feature that allows you to take your private or secure lockers to a different level, where you can, of course, add in all your different contacts. You can add in applications into the locker. So your locker becomes almost a different home base for your device. You can make it business or personal. You can separate it in any different way you want, using, of course, your PIN or fingerprint sensor. Now, the fingerprint sensor is still located on the space bar on the keyboard, which is nice, really nice form of functionality there with the device. I think that's pretty cool. You've also got a power management tool that uses AI functionality that's built into the chipset to actually watch how you're using your device. So if you are charging at certain times of the day, it will send you reminders about charging, if how you're using your device, if you're using it for long periods of time, it will send those reminders before it hits 15%. It will tell you, hey, look, the way you're using your device now, you're not going to last your normal, say, 20 hours. You might want to top it off now if you want to reach those 20 hours. So I like that kind of thinking where it looks like the AI functionality is taking that proactive step rather than it waiting for preconceived times to tell you, hey, you want to go charge your device. So that's pretty cool. And then finally, of course, you've got a dual camera setup. So BlackBerry has now finally had a dual camera setup. Bokeh Effect, of course, is located with this, or at least is available. And my buddy Ricky is posing for me here. And you can see it looks pretty good against off the device screen. It's a 1080p display, but it looks really nice. And I think it's something that a lot of people will like. You've also got a manual mode on that camera. It records 4K 30. Not 4K 60, but again, like I said, it's the Snapdragon 660 processor. I think overall, this device brings a lot to the table that sets it apart and different. You've also got two different color variants. You've got the all black, which looks pretty nice. That Spider-Man wallpaper looks pretty dope on it too. And trust me guys, I'll leave a link for you guys so you can download the wallpaper. But you've also got a silver and black version, which is very nice as well. Now this device charges via USB Type-C. It's got a headphone jack as well. And it's got this really nice finish. Now I know one person who would be really happy with this device is Mr. Juan Bagnell from Some Gadget Guy, because you know he likes the whole idea of niche devices. And I do agree that the market is getting very differentiated this year. So I'm not sure if the BlackBerry Key 2 is for you, but this gives and provides something that's very different from everyone else, especially on the security features, the battery life functionality, as well as also the keyboard and some of the multitasking and productivity features you find with this device. So if you have any questions or any comments, let me know. Otherwise, don't forget to like and share this video, favorite this video, subscribe to the channel, and always enjoy your entertainment.